We're not just a youth service provider. We also provide an alternative to what's out there for local young people. We actually have a different power structure for young people. We ask young people to get involved in governance, decision making, but we do it again in a creative way so that they understand the impact they are making to themselves and to the community.
I'm Humaira and I work at Leaders in Community. I actually started off with Leaders in Community as part of the Be Inspired programme, and now many years later they still haven't been able to get rid of me. So today I'm interviewing Momtaz to look back at her journey through LIC. Hope you enjoy. Hi Momtaz, thank you for agreeing to do this with me. I feel privileged as a former young person who you have mentored yourself. So in honour of your journey at Leaders in Community, I have a few questions which I would like to ask. The first question I would like to ask is, what made you start Leaders in Community?
Gosh, what made me start Leaders in Community? A lot of things made me start Leaders in Community. One of them, and you know, a lot of you know this, is my own personal struggle into employment. I felt I had a lot of self-confidence, self-esteem, never really believed in myself, and I didn't think I would be successful in life. When I met my true mentor, who helped me overcome a lot of those challenged personal barriers I had, I really felt like there were other women from my similar background, from this estate, who would be suffering in the way that I've been suffering. Those were the small triggers that really made me think that, you know, we all need to come together and create something where we had a platform to speak up, where we were able to share skills and knowledge because we were all from similar backgrounds. A safe place to be and to talk and to develop. And that was really the stepping stone.
What's been your most memorable experience?
My most memorable experience, probably being awarded the Queen's Award, going up to Buckingham Palace was quite a nice experience. You know, to be recognised for the work that we do, that's a pretty awesome experience, and that probably stayed with me for a very, very long time. I mean, other experiences are working with you, Mo, you've been with me since you were 14. Those are special moments. Working with true stars are special moments.
What are your hopes for the future of Leaders in Community?
My hopes for the future for Leaders in Community, we're at such a good place. We've got some great members of the team. We've got lovely young people coming through our doors. We've got our own home. We've got beautiful surroundings. It's always to work on a grassroots level, always to work on a state level, because that's where the job really matters. Super local, super grassroots is where it really, your work will really make big difference. So continue that work. Continue spreading Leaders in Community's message of empowerment, youth development and youth voice, and continue to represent young people, represent young women. Speak up for young people who are voiceless, speak up for the community that cannot speak up, because we have a platform now and we have a real good credibility. So use that platform positively and keep telling the world what you're doing and build. You can only build up now, so I have lots of hopes for LIC and I know it will do great things because it's just developing some wonderful leaders.
What challenges have you faced during your time at Leaders in Community?
The most challenging is, I guess, I never knew how much work it would take to start an organisation. From the very first thing that you do, it's just constantly thinking and planning and thinking about risks and thinking about long-term plans. There were so many triumphs, but there were equal amount of like lows. And I think there were days when I would stress about how I would get people paid or how I'd pay for things. Am I over-promising? Am I under-delivering? You know, there are all those things you have to constantly toy with. And those are challenges you go through regardless of how much experience have. And bear in mind, almost 14 years ago, I was pretty young myself, so I didn't know a whole lot about life or the world.
So who would you say inspires you?
Who inspired me in the early days? are, this is going to sound cliche, but the women around me, from my mother to my sisters to my girlfriends, they inspired me because each and every one of them were going through our own personal struggles, just to see how resilient those women around me were. And then I met some inspirational people who were my mentors, who are still my mentors today. I've learned about their own challenges or their route to leadership or their journey into activism, and I just felt that's where I want to be. So I name drop some people. Anna May, I owe her a lot. Constantly guiding me, give me advice to this day. Xanthi, our fundraiser, she's been a mentor of mine. Somebody called Simon Carroll from Poplar Harker also has been, he's the person that planted the seed, and really I owe him everything. And I don't know if he knows it, so I suppose I should dedicate this film to him.
Hey Momtaz, I just want to say a huge thank you for being such a great role model for us girls, for being a CEO, and especially for us brand girls, showing us the amazing things we can achieve just like you.
I can't believe this is the kind of end of our time together at LIC. I just want to say a massive thank you for everything you've done.
For me, for the team, for LIC, and all the effort you put into what you truly believe in.
I know everyone at LIC, from the board, the colleagues, volunteers, young people, we're all thankful for your grit, your passion, your determination and leadership.
I can't believe it's been like 12 years since I've known you.
From me being on the board and doing the marketing to now being on the team. So thank you for seeing something in me and pushing me to kind of make that step and be a bigger part of LIC.
And the journey that I've taken with you and LIC over the last 12 years has been amazing. You gave me the opportunity to build and give back to the organisation that gave me everything.
You've just supported me throughout my whole journey. And I personally owe a lot of my development to you.
And I hope we can make you proud and build on your legacy, because that is all anyone can hope to do. You've really set the groundwork, and I hope we can maintain that and make you proud.
I'd like to thank you for your mentorship. When I came into LIC 10 years ago, into Limborough House, you saw something in me and you allowed me the platform to grow, to develop my leadership qualities. And for that, I'm thankful, and I know for sure that my mum's thankful as well.
The fact that you had faith and trust in me to take on so much responsibility at such a young age means the world. I've learned so much from you. I owe you and LIC everything for helping me get to where I am today and inspiring me to take up opportunities to always keep pushing myself forward.
I still remember meeting you and Aisha in the old office in, I think it was March 2016, so almost 6 years ago now.
Thank you so much for all your hard work and efforts for LIC. We all enjoy the courses so much, for all the efforts you've made for us to become amazing young people that we are today.
It's a privilege to know such an inspiring woman who cares so deeply about the community. So many kids wouldn't have an opportunity at various different things without you, so for that I am eternally grateful.
Supporting me whilst I was in New York, and between you and the other board members, letting me still stay part of LIC, and you know, holding the phone whilst I spoke from New York and tried to listen in before we had Zoom and all those sorts of things that now exist.
You've been missed dearly by us, and we're so grateful for you, for everything you achieved in this, for leaders and community, and the amazing things we have done because of you. And we will miss you, and we love you, and thank you for everything you've done. Thanks, Momtaz.
Thank you so much. We miss you so much.
Momtaz, I'd like to say goodbye, and I know this isn't farewell, and I want to wish you all the best for the future.
And honestly, you'll be really, really missed. I hope this isn't goodbye. I hope we stay in touch, and I really want to hear how you're getting on. So good luck in the next chapter. I really, really do wish you all the best, and I really do hope to stay in contact.
No doubt we'll cross paths in the future, and hopefully we'll work together. I wish the best for your future, and I hope to see you very soon.